Hi, this is Sanjay Gangal from MCAT Cafe. I'm here with Andrew Krashi, General Manager at NVIDIA. Hello, Andrew.
Sanjay, great to meet you.
Nice to meet you also. Andrew, how's the show been going for you?
Actually, it's been a really nice mood. There are a lot of great customers coming by, lots of great questions. So this is the meat and potatoes of our business, CAD/CAM. So we're in the business of doing high-performance visualization and computation. So perfect show for us. It's great.
So tell us about NVIDIA itself, about the company, and how much have you been involved in this CAD/CAM world for how many years?
As I say, it's the heart and soul of our business. So CAD/CAM is probably 40% of our business. It's a very big piece of our business. And Autodesk, you know, is a very big partner, huge volume. So historically, we've been providing really high-quality visualization, you know, getting the high quality displays so you can make sense of all the solid modeling that you're doing. That's core to our business. More recent, we've been focused on simulation and rendering. So one of the things we're doing at the show today is we're announcing a Maximus technology. So this is what we're seeing from customers is what I call a collapsing of workflow. More people are doing more of the workflow than ever before. Mm-hmm. So for example, somebody's doing solids modeling, they're also doing analysis, or they're also doing rendering, just to speed the whole cycle up. And so what happens is if you're doing some solids modeling and then you do a rendering, your machine stops. That's not good. Then you go off and get a cup of coffee, you go home for the evening, and it's kind of wasted time. So Maximus puts a compute GPU in as well as a graphics GPU into the same machine so that you can keep running Inventor or AutoCAD, and then you kick off a Moleflow analysis or you kick off a 3D Studio Max rendering, and you keep running at the same time. So everything's still running at real time. It's staggering. We've got people coming around. They love this. It's really been really useful on the show.
That's pretty interesting. Certainly rendering or analysis would be going on the GPU while people can continue to use the computer, say for email or anything
else. Absolutely. Well, no, you can keep doing solids modeling.
I see.
So if you're running Inventor, you're changing something and you keep modeling, but you're still running your analysis on something you did before, it doesn't stop your machine. You keep going. So please come by and take a look at it, by the way.
Okay. So NVIDIA is generally hidden behind curtains, right? People generally don't see. I mean, sometimes they see the NVIDIA logo in front of the computer. But if somebody were to ask you, I must look for this particular thing for Inventor or for modeling or for simulation analysis, what would you tell them? What's the most powerful GPUs do you have?
Well, so first of all, I'd suggest ask for this new thing we just launched, Maximus. So all the OEMs, the HPs, the Dells, the Lenovo's, they're all shipping Maximus configurations. That's basically two GPUs in a system. One is for graphics, and the other one is for compute. Other than that, you can ask for Quadro. So we do some great Quadro cards, all the way from the Quadro 600 all the way to a Quadro 6000. It's got 6 gigabytes of memory in it. It's a fantastic big card. Or on the Tesla side for compute is a C2075. So those are if you want to go down to the card level or just go ask for Maximus, that's just the easiest way.
Okay, and how can people find out more about Maximus and any of the other GPUs that you have?
Well, that's first thing, you can go to NVIDIA.com or you can go to HP or Lenovo or Dell, but go to NVIDIA.com and just do a search on Maximus. Just do a Google search in it. There's plenty of material in it right now. There is one other thing I wanted to talk about on the show that I think is pretty exciting. So Carl Bass, when he was talking to the press, I think it was Monday, he talked about something called Project Pandora. Now this, I think, is going to be really cool. This is for this 3D Studio Max audience. And it enables you to render in the cloud. So today, 3D Studio Max, our users are coming to us all the time going, how do I build a bigger machine so I get faster rendering? So this is a way it solves this problem, because you can now go and assign as many GPUs as you want at Amazon. So when you click render, instead of rendering locally, you say render in the cloud, and it'll shoot it off to Amazon, and I can say I've got a really fast project. I've either got to do a really big scale print, or I've got a customer coming in, I've got to turn this rendering really fast. So I can go throw 32 GPUs at this. I can get it done. Something that would take me a day and a half, I could do it in an hour.
That's pretty impressive.
It's super cool. Now, this is a technology preview. I'm very excited. The guys are going to release it in some upcoming version of 3D Studio Max. Okay. And it's a joint project. So we're working with Autodesk. We're writing it together. So I'd encourage all of you guys to come and take a look at that at the booth as well.
And that's pretty awesome. Anything else that you wanted to cover?
I think I've given you enough today. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Andrew, for coming over talking to us.
Thank you.